Hi, my name's Andy Spoon. Today I'd like to talk about how to get best results with PASCO's interference and diffraction experiment. Let's begin by taking a sample data set. I'm going to start recording in Data Studio, and then I'm going to carefully rotate the large ring of the rotational motion sensor across my interference pattern. Feel free to pause and adjust your hand as you go across. Once you get across the entire interference pattern, you can stop collecting data. Now let's talk about how I achieve these results. First of all, I'm using the high precision diffraction and interference slits. This product comes with two different discs, a single slit disc and a multiple slit disc. The multiple slit disc, I'm using the first option for the double slit. Also attached to my basic optics track is the basic optics red diode laser and the linear translator. Notice here I have the linear translator and the red laser as far apart as possible. I have the laser at approximately 0 centimeters, the multiple slits are approximately at 11 centimeters, and the aperture bracket is lined up at approximately 103 centimeters. The aperture bracket is attached to the light sensor. The light sensor is set to a sensitivity of a medium range, and the aperture bracket is set to slit number 4. Slit number 4 allows enough light to get in so I can see my results in Data Studio, but also minimizes the spacing in between the interference patterns so I can easily differentiate between one maxima to the next. Now, if I would like to increase my interference pattern sensitivity, I could use the high sensitivity light sensor. This is especially useful if I start using my finer interference patterns included with the multiple slit disc. It also includes three different sensitivity settings, very similar to the regular light sensor. And finally, for best consistency results, I have a stop on my linear translator that allows me to move my rotary motion sensor to the same point each time. This allows the rotary motion sensor to take that at 0 centimeters whenever I begin every data collection run. I hope these tips help you get great results in your lab. Thanks for joining us.